Namaste and welcome to the Jyotishi YouTube channel. Today we are going to start the new year with a new video about Makara Sankranti. So Sun is going to enter the sign of Makara, that is the sign of Capricorn, and what is the importance of it both culturally, spiritually and from an astrology perspective. Coming Thursday is Makara Sankranti, where yes. The sun moves into the sign of Aries, right? Yes. Also known as winter solstice.
Yes.
So what is the significance of Makara Sankranti and why is it celebrated in India?
Yes. So we all know that there are 12 Adityas. So Rigveda defines 7 Adityas. The Bhagavad Purana, the Bhagavatam defines 12 Adityas. So, Aditya primarily represents purity as per Rigveda. It represents, cleanliness. It represents spiritual evolution kind of a thing. And it is a variant of Surya. It is a different form of Surya. So, there are 12 Adityas as per in different signs, from Aries to Pisces. And Sankranti means it is movement from one phase to another phase.
Okay.
So it also indicates the entry of Surya in a particular sign.
Right.
So the sun, when it enters one particular sign, or a transformation of the sun into a different variant of an Aditya, is called Sankranti. So like that, we have 12 Sankrantis in our system. So out of these 12, 4 Sankrantis are given reasonably good importance. So, based on the 4 the padas in our life. So for example, dharma, artha, kama and moksha.
Okay.
So, Sankranti where sun enters Makara or the Capricorn is called Makara Sankranti. So, the 0 degree entry of sun from Sagittarius to Capricorn, which is called Makara, and hence it's called Makara Sankranti. And this marks the end of the winter solstice. It marks the beginning of the Uttarayan.
Okay.
It is the upward journey, northward journey of the sun.
Right.
And the longest nights, therefore, are over. And now it's the phase of the sun, the days where it is longer. So the Uttarayan starts now. And this particular Sankranti marks the beginning of the moksha trikona, the moksha element in our life. So the out of the 4 paths that we take, this marks the beginning of moksha in our life, and hence it is very, very important, since Hinduism, Sanatana Dharma, primarily believes in the moksha and then
right.
connecting with the soul, kind of a thing. And hence this Sankranti is given the very, very great importance from that particular perspective.
Right. So what about the other 3? Like, before we move more dive deeper into moksha,
yes.
what about the other 3 aspects of life?
Yes.
When is that celebrated and how is that
yes.
celebrated?
So we have the month of April, we have the Dharma Sankranti. So we have the Kama Sankranti in the month of August, September.
Okay.
Then we have the Moksha Sankranti in the month of January. So
right.
typically, there is a story where Bhishma Pitama gave up his life. He was waiting to give up his life on this particular day, because
okay.
it probably grants that the spiritual energies are so high that in terms of moksha, it is supposed to be the best day for, sort of giving up. So he was waiting on the bed of arrows
right.
for this particular day, just after the Vishnu Sahasranam was chanted, and then he was waiting for this particular day for him to kind of give up and then give up his life and then move on to another soul kind of a thing.
So this starts with, typically there is a puja at home that is
yes,
done, right,
yes.
on Makara Sankranti
yes.
day. So apart from doing a puja, what could also be done so that you move in that direction?
So there are multiple stories. We'll come to the cultural aspect of it later after this spiritual aspect is touched upon. So one, we talked about Bhishma Pitama. Another story talks about Sankranti killing the demon Shankarasur. Another story talks about Vishnu eliminating, evil from this world, and hence
right.
we celebrate. The most commonly known story is Surya and Shani are father and son. And Capricorn, Makara is ruled by Shani.
Right.
And father is coming, that is Raja. Surya is Raja. Raja is coming to Praja's house. So Surya is coming to Shani's house. And father is coming to the son's house. But father and son don't have a reasonably good relationship. So there is a beautiful story behind it. So Surya married Sanjana. And then he had three children, Yama, Yami and Vivaswat. The Vivaswat thing. And then Sanjana was not able to bear the rays, the heat from the rays of Surya. So she had a sort of look-alike Chaya created for Surya to... So Chaya is a shadow anyway.
Yes.
And Chaya would be affected. So Surya had again three children with Chaya. And Shani was one of those children with Chaya. So Shani, then you have Manu and all that. So Shani was sort of reasonably... Shani has this particular beautiful thing that if Shani looks at... So many cultures in this country don't even spell out Shani because of the fear that Shani carries. So Shani, with a glare in your eyes, Shani can lead a disaster, you know, lead to disaster sort of thing. So there is a story about Shani and Ganesha as well. So Surya sort of found out that, you know, Chaya was not his actual wife and then got angry at Shani, and Shani being a small kid glared at Surya, and then Surya got leprosy. Then looked at Varuna,
right.
the charioteer of Surya, and then Varuna lost his eyes and all that. So Shani has that powerful kind of a thing. So because Shani was sort of dark because of this Chaya being the shadow kind of a thing, and then the differences sort of... if you have to move to a moksha or a spiritual platform, you have to leave away all your differences. So that is what this particular day signifies, where the differences are kind of left out, and then Surya comes into Shani's house, and then the Shani offers til or sesame
right.
seeds kind of a thing. So sesame seeds also has a beautiful thing. So it is sort of representative form of Vishnu's sweat.
Yes.
So it has great significance from that impact. So Shani offered sesame seeds. So it's sort of believed that your spiritual progress will start once you clear out all your differences.
Right.
And then, you know, your journey can start with offering of sesame seeds and jaggery.
Yeah.
You know, so that's why we have this gajak and
right.
Til and those kind of things.
Which is had.
Yes. And as Til is also important in moksha. So when we, you know, sort of do Shrard for your ancestors, till because it's Vishnu's representative,
yes.
and that's why, you know, sort of you give that. So from that perspective, it is also a day for moksha, like Bhishma Pitama waited for this day. It is also a day to clear out all your differences and then move into a spiritual
right.
kind of a direction. So from that perspective, spiritually, it is a very significant
right.
day. So we all know Kumbh Mela is celebrated
yes.
on this particular
yes.
day. We also know that Lord Ayyappa, comes this particular
yes.
day to Shabrimala and then blesses all the people kind of thing. So it has great spiritual significance. And from a cultural perspective, various, this is one festival where different parts of the country celebrate the same festival, maybe in a different name.
Way.
So we have Bigu, we have Pongal, we have Atta Pongal, we have Makara Sankranti, we have different names
yes.
in different parts of the country. So Uttaranchal has a different name. Himachal is a different name kind of a thing, and it marks the harvest festival, the
right.
You know, sort of winter getting over, summer
yes.
coming up, and then harvesting is like you get paddy, sugar cane
right.
and all those things, and those
feel
harvests,
the abundance.
Yes, feel the abundance of those festivals, and then you happily share it with people,
yes.
and to share it with people, you need to kind of meet people
Correct.
And then
yeah.
sort of greet each other. So it marks from a sort of cultural significance, that is what it marks. It's a harbinger of, you know, coming together.
Yes.
It's also marks the beginning of sharing with people
right.
and those kind of things.
It also inculcates, so when you, the sense of gratitude, right?
Yes.
When you see
yes.
a lot of sugar cane,
yes.
and when you see a lot of
paddy
and
yes.
all of that in your house, then you're
yes.
grateful and you're giving it away. So that sense of abundance comes within you.
Yes. Right? So we are primarily grateful to each other. We are also primarily grateful to Surya, who as per Rigveda and Bhagavatam is a representative of Vishnu as 12 Adityas. And then you are grateful for Surya to give life on this earth, because without Surya, without life, there is no life. So from that point of view, it is gratitude expressed to Surya, gratitude expressed to all of us. And the fantastic thing to do is to chant Gayatri Mantra on that particular day as a gratitude to Gayatri. And you can also chant Japa Kusuma Samkasham Kashapeyam Maha. So Surya's mantra, Surya's Gayatri is also a good thing to sort of chant on this particular day.
What about Aditya Hridayam or any of
those? Yes, Aditya Hridayam is also fantastic. So 12 Adityas are sons of Aditi.
Right.
So from that perspective, when Aditya Hridayam was given by Rama, given to Rama for victory. Yes. So it also marks the celebration of weakness, bad over goodness, and then weakness over strength. So you sort of get strength to kind
strength over weakness.
Yes, strength over weakness kind of a thing. So
from good that over perspective, bad and strength over
weakness. So from that perspective, Aditya Hridayam is also good.
So this particular year is special because Saturn is in its own house in Makara, and Sun transiting Saturn, what does it signify?
So Sun will enter, this father will send enter the Sun's house, clearing all the differences.
Right.
So they're, ideally, they are sort of not very in very good terms because of this story that I mentioned. They clear all the differences, they enter, and the first nakshatra, so each house is divided into three nakshatras, right? So we have 27 nakshatras. So the first nakshatra is called Uttarashada. So in southern part of the country, it's called Uttradam nakshatra. So Uttradam is ruled by the 10 Vishwadevas.
Right.
So it is also, so Vishwadevas are like Kama, Kala. So they are all representative of 10 natures that we have.
Okay.
So so it is also, the Vishwadevas are also part of a solar kind of a deity. So it enters this particular nakshatra. And then Saturn sort of welcomes father with the season seeds and all that. So it is from that perspective, ideally the problems that could happen due to a Sun-Saturn combination is sort of reasonably debilitated at this particular time.
Okay.
From that perspective, it is a reasonably good transition.
Okay. So any changes that we can see in the world that you would want to talk about?
From a changes perspective,
it a positive direction that we are moving towards?
Yes, from a direction perspective, it is a positive direction that we are moving. And then there can be sort of this 1 month is a good time frame to sort of clear out differences between the Raja and the Praja. So if there are any issues between government and masses, which there are at this current point in time, this 1 month is a beautiful time frame to clear all those, let us put it this way, it's a high probability time frame to clear out differences.
That things will get better.
Yes, things ideally should get better if there is an initiative.
Got it.
Because the Raja is taking initiative to, you know, come down and then figure out things.
Needs people. And
yes. Okay. So ideally, if it is done in this particular time frame, it is good.
So, like last question with regards to astrology and this, right? Jupiter being in association with this, will that make any difference?
Yes. So, spiritual combinations, there are various spiritual combinations. So, Saturn denotes a tapasvi, so hardcore tapasvi. So, Sun denotes spiritual, Sun's spiritual perspective denotes, you know, sort of a light, a show off kind of a thing. And Venus, when it comes, it shows diplomacy. So all these four planets are in that particular
Jupiter
with Jupiter as well. So the intensity of spirituality is supposed to be increasing.
Okay.
And the intensity of tapasvi oriented spirituality is supposed to be increasing.
Okay.
Not from a show off perspective. The person who does spirituality, does prayers from his home, who's not, you know, sort of outward and does not want to show off kind of a thing. That kind of spirituality perspective in this 1 month is pretty good.
Okay. So, Makara Sankranti, also known as winter solstice, like Anand mentioned, has multiple significances. One is, it is a very good time to move towards moksha. culturally, it also marks the importance of feeling abundant and feeling grateful, right? Like sun is the giver of life in this planet. So you look at all that you have grown over the years, you bring in sugarcane at home, right? And then you celebrate this with the feeling of abundance and meeting people. And also this time, Saturn being in its own house and three other planets, which is Sun, Venus and Jupiter being there, is a great time to move towards spirituality, like Anand mentioned. Thank you for watching the Jyotishi YouTube channel. Please subscribe.